हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम संपदा कुलकर्णी वेलकम्स यू इन माय चैनल टेक टॉक्स। इन दिस वीडियो सीरीज आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग यू द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ ट्री डेटा स्ट्रक्चर। बिफोर मूविंग टू द कंटेंट्स, आई वुड लाइक टू रिक्वेस्ट यू टू सब्सक्राइब माय चैनल टेक टॉक्स एंड कीप द बेल रिंगिंग। So let's focus on tree traversals. There are basically two techniques of the tree traversal. They are DFS, that is depth first search, and the BFS, which is breadth first search. Depth first search is the algorithm or the technique. There are again three sub techniques. They are pre-order, in-order and post-order. These three techniques are basically depend on the position of root node. I have already explained all these things in detail in my introduction wala video. For your reference, I am providing a shortcut link in this right up corner. You can go through that and you can resume this video. Now let's go forward for the another technique, which is nothing but the breadth first search traversal. So this is breadth first traversal. Breadth is nothing but the level or in the level in which the tree grows. So that's why in this breadth first traversal, the tree will get traversed according to level. It is also called as level order traversal. Now let's move to the main concept of today's video session, is binary tree traversal, from which we are going to study the depth first traversal technique, which is in order and where we supposed to follow the order left node, then root, then the right node. So let's go forward for the content. So in this left order traversal, as I explained you, the left root node and right, the same sequence we have to follow. So I am reminding you to follow the sequence of first of all left, then you have to follow the next sequence is about the root node, that is processing of the root node, and after root node we have to go to the right subtree. So in this way we have to follow the sequence left node, root node and the right node, or we can also say that left subtree, then root node and then a right subtree. Now let's move forward for the example where I am going to explain you the in order traversal. Before that, let's see what will be the result if I will traverse this given tree into in order traversal, where the root node is A, left child is B and right child is C. So first of all, what we supposed to do? Yes, we supposed to traverse a left child. Which one is the left child? Yes, you are very correct, the left child is B. So process first of all root left child B. So here we have processed the left child B. Then we have to go back to the root node. How to go back? Because tree is a data structure where there are no any backtracking, back linking is available, because A will be having the address of B, and means it left child, B is not having the address of its root node. So where to go back? For this I am going to explain you in the next few slides. So after this left child is completed, where we need to go? We need to go for a root node. Which one is the root node? Root node is A. So process a root node. Then after completion of a root node, we need to go to the right child. So go for a right. Which one is the right child? C is the right child. So C we need to process. As I explained you previously, that how we need to perform all these things, how we have to go back to the root node, how we have to process a root node, then how we have to move to the right child. So this how is a question, how to perform all these things, that we supposed to use the algorithms. So for this, what is the solution? Solution is recursive and non-recursive algorithms. So this is the solution, how to traverse the binary tree in any of the order we are having the algorithms for the same. So solution is nothing but the algorithms that we can traverse in two ways, that is in recursive way and in non-recursive way. So in this specific or in this current video session, I am explaining you only the recursive in order binary tree traversal. How to traverse the binary tree recursively but in order, that I am going to explain you in this video session. So let's start with the example and its algorithm. So the algorithm, recursive algorithm, I am going to show over in this slide, where this recursive algorithm, where we have to write down the function, the name given by me is in order, and we have to, or we supposed to pass the root node to this particular function. Whenever you are going to pass a root node, you are making a copy of a root node. We have to check, very first step is root node is not equal to null. If it is not equal to null, then if the condition is true, you have to enter into the if condition, and your first step is recursively call the in order function again by passing its left child as a root node. Now this left child will become a root node or a copy of a root node, and again you have to check whether the root node is not equal to null. You have to continue this step to call the in order function recursively by passing a left child. You have to continue this process till your left child is not equal to null. Once it is equal to null, it will get exited from the function, current function, because it is a recursive algorithm. You must know the concept of recursive algorithm before moving to this particular video session, because it is a very important concept, and you must know how the recursive function will get executed and how it makes different copies of the what we can say variables. So after this, the next step is we need to process the root node. After processing, it means displaying the root node. So after processing of the root node, you can move forward to the next step. For the next step, we have to go for a right child recursively by calling the in order function. So it will again go back to the same function, making the right child as a root node, and then we have to again check whether my current root node is not equal to null. If it is not equal to null, if the condition is true, again for a current root node which was the right child previously, for that child let's check whether the left child is present or not. I have already explained all these things theoretically in the previous video session with the five different examples. So you must be knowing the sequence what we supposed to follow. Here in this video session, I am explaining you how to perform that traversal with the help of programming language or with the help of the algorithm. And that's why I am explaining you again a short example in the next slide. So let's focus on the steps. So what are the steps? So here I am focusing on the step. So first of all, you need to check whether the root node is not equal to null. If the root node is not equal to null, you have to call the function recursively by passing the left child as a parameter till the root is not equal to null. Current root is not equal to null. If it is equal to null, process a root node and go forward for the next step, where again recursively call the in order function, where here now after left root, it is a turn to pass a right child. So pass a right child to the function and make it as a root. Let's check whether the current root is not equal to null, and again call the left child of a current root node. So this process you have to perform recursively, and then you can go forward for the result what you will receive from the recursive algorithm. Now let's move forward for the next slide, where I am going to explain you the example. Here the simple example I have taken in this video session. For the next example, you can tune with the tech talks, and in the next video session I am going to explain you the next another wala example. So here A is a root node, B is its left child and C is its right child. Let's start for the execution of algorithm. Here I have given three boxes because recursively we are going to call a function, and for that every time it is going to make a separate copy of all the variables whenever the recursive function is concerned. So now let's start. This is your in order function call, where currently a root node is A. Here I am going to give you the result or the output of this recursive function call. Now this is the box where I am going to work for the root node A when the root node is A. So initially whenever we are going to call a function, A is a root node and which will get passed to the function in order. Now let's see what is going to be happen further step by step. So my first condition is to check whether the root node is not equal to null. No, it's not equal to null because root is having the node A. My step number one is calling a in order recursive function by passing a left child as a root node. So now what will happen? Let's see. So here I am going to moving from or switching from this block to this second block where the in order function is there, and now my current root node, which was previously a left child, the current root node is B. Here you can see that A is having a left child B, and we are passing this B as a root node or a parameter to the recursive function in order. Here we are starting again the recursive function which is in order, and here we are making a copy of a root node who is having the value node B. So now here in this block you can say that the root node is B. We are going to treat B as a root node. Now let's move forward. Let's check whether the condition is true or false. Root is not equal to null. The condition is true because currently root is having a node B. Again, make a recursive function call to in order function by passing a left child of a root node B. Which one is the left child of root node? It is a null value. Here you can see that no any left child is present. Ultimately it is a null value. So whenever it is a null value, you can see that we are moving from this block to the another block by making a copy of a root node equal to null. But if the root node equal to null, we are knowing that if the condition is false, where we need to go back to the previous function call and to the next step. So let's return back, and here we are moving to the next step, that is step number 2, is process a root node. So which root node you have to process? The current copy of a root node you have to process. Which one is the current root node? Your current root node is B, and we have to process a B. Here you can see that I have processed the root node B. Now let's move forward for the next step, that is step number 3. In the step number 3, again you have to make a call, recursive call to in order function by passing the right child of current root node. Which one is the right child of current root node? Here you can see that the right child is not present for a root node B. It means that it is a null value. Let's check how it is going to be executed. Let's move forward. Here a root node is null because right child B or a right child of B is not present. So that's why it is null. And what it will do? It will return back to the previous function call or a previous block. Here in this block it will return back, and where it will go? It will go to the next statement. Which one is the next statement? Is nothing but the completion of this if statement. If statement is completed means where it will go? It will go to the next statement, that is completion of the in order function. Here you have done the execution of in order function where the root node was B. Where it will go? Can you imagine where it will go? Here I am explaining you where it will return back. It will return back to the previous function call. From this whole block, where it will return back? It will return back to the previous function call from where you have called this block. So from where you have called this block, I am showing you all these things with the help of arrows. for the better understanding of this algorithm. So from where you have made the call? You have made the call from this block where root node was A. So it is returning back to the next statement. The statement number 2 is nothing but the processing of the root node. So what will be our next step is to process a root node. So here you can see over here the in-order traversal, the result will be having the root node A, which is processed, or the displaying of a root node. After completion of this step, where we need to go? We need to go to the step number 3. In the step number 3, you have to call a function recursively by passing a right child as a root node. So which one is the root node currently? A is a root node. Is having the right child? Here you can see that yes, A is having a right child whose name is C. Now what we need to do? We need to call this function recursively by passing a right child as a root node. So C is a right child, and by passing this C as a root node or a right child as a root node, where it will go? Here you can see that we are moving to the another block where this is the space separately allotted for the recursive function call, where root node is nothing but C. Here you can see that the new copy of a recursive function is there, and where root node is C. Root node is C, and let's go forward for the condition whether my root is not equal to null. Yes, the condition is true. It means that we have to enter into the if condition, and my first step is to call the function recursively by passing its left child as a root node. So you can see over here, this C is a node where C is not having its left child. It means that the C's left child is null. So now let's see what is going to be happen. It will move to the another block, and let's check which one is the root node. Root node is null. As our condition says that root is not equal to null, if the condition is false, it returns back to the next statement, and next statement is to process a root node. After processing of a root node, it means that it is displaying a current root node. Which one is the current root node? Is nothing but C, and here you can see that we are displaying a root node C over here. After this, let's move to the next step. In order traversal, recursively calling to the function by passing a right child as a right child as a root node, and let's pass this right child, C's right child. C is having not having a right child, it means it is null, and passing a null value to the function, it returns to the next statement, and next statement is nothing but the completion of the if statement. It after the next statement is the completion of the in order traversal, and it will return back from where it was called. Here it was called from the block where root node was A, and it will move to the next statement. Next statement is nothing but the completion of if and completion of your in order traversal. So in this way, the recursive function call is going to be used while traversing the algorithm. Whenever you are moving from A to B and from B to its root node again, so this recursive function call helps us to move back to the previous level where it was not possible easily with the tree data structure, because tree data structure is having only the links from parent to child node. There are no any links available from child to parent node. So to go back from child to parent node, this recursive function call helps us to move from the down level to the upper level, or from child level to the parent level. So thank you dear friends for listening and watching my video. If you like the content and the video, please subscribe my channel Tech Talks, and here I am providing you a shortcut link for the next video of this video series, along with the shortcut for the video series in the form of playlist. Thank you.